Good afternoon, and welcome to the 2015 State of the City Address, a time designated to not only reflect on city accomplishments in the past year, but to also review plans for the future of East Chicago. We would like to thank you for taking time out of your busy schedules to be with us today. The City of East Chicago is definitely doing many positive things, and I'm very excited about the future. At this time, I would like to acknowledge all of the government and elected officials. Would you please stand? Thank you so much for being here. And now we'll get started with the posting of the colors by American Legion Post 369.
Say, can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bursting in air gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet
a round of applause as they exit. Up next, we will have an invocation by Captain Daniel Paredes.
Please, let's pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you. And first of all, we honor you as a creator, sustainer, and holder of everything. Father, in the name of Jesus, we declare that your presence is here, not just in this sanctuary or in this ceremony, but you are in East Chicago. Father, in the name of Jesus, we declare this ceremony and this declaration today. Everything that we do, we think, and we speak, we want to honor you for your glory and honor. In Jesus' name, amen.
The Bible says in Proverbs 29:18, where there is no vision, the people perish. True leadership is defined by results, not attributes. In periods where there is no vision or leadership, society stands still. Progress only occurs when courageous, skillful leaders seize the opportunity to change things for the better. And so a great leader is one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. Napoleon once said that a leader is a dealer in hope. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand to your feet as we bring to the stage at this time the man behind the vision and the leader of this great city, the Honorable Mayor Anthony Copeland.
Let me start off, by reflecting on something that happened earlier this week. And I didn't have the opportunity to embed it in my speech. On Tuesday, I was down at the state capitol, and we were dealing with Klein Avenue. Excuse me. And when I sat there, we were trying to put the last pieces of the Klein Avenue deal together. Mrs. Figg was there from the Figg Bridge Company, and we sat before the committee. Got up and I told them the many reasons on why we needed Klein Avenue. And the reason I'm putting this in front of the speech is because I was humbled. The late, great Earl Harris, who is not with us now, I sat there before nine of his colleagues. And as I passionately asked that Klein Avenue rise from the ashes, they reminded me how they were constantly goaded and constantly consulted about why Klein should be up, and behind the scenes how Earl Harris had been navigating this thing on both sides of the aisle. And it was, excuse me, it was nine members there, and it passed 9-0, and they did that in honor of Earl Harris. So I am proud to tell you that Klein Avenue shall rise again starting this construction season. Let me start by acknowledging those that are here today. To my fellow elected officials, to my wife Carolyn, family, friends, distinguished and honored guests, I would like to extend my heartfelt thanks to everyone for your continual support. To the churches and clergy, thank you for your prayers. They are truly appreciated. Individual commitment to a group effort is what makes a team work. To my staff and department heads, it is your labor that keeps this city running efficiently. And I am blessed to know that much has been accomplished because of the dedication from the men and women who work in this great city. Without you, our success would not be possible. Thank you. So what is the state of our city? While we cannot erase history, we have demonstrated that by eliminating a $15 million budget deficit and creating a balanced budget, that we can now invest in a promising future. Where we were once known for graft and corruption, we are now a city that is underway. Let me share with you Let me share with you some of our past efforts. We have invested $3.3 million in new park equipment throughout the city, improving the quality of life for children, family, and our senior citizens. In October 2014, we broke ground on the city's first roundabout. Roundabouts may take a bit of adjustment for drivers, but roundabouts are proven to reduce accidents, increase safety, and help move traffic along. We invested in our streets, reconstruction of 145th and Bering to Homer Lee, Northcott from 151st to Chicago Avenue, all this in the past year. We also spent more than $800,000 on resurfacing streets as needed. In November, we launched eChicago Works 311, a new phone app that allows residents to quickly report issues such as potholes, graffiti, and streetlight outages. The system also allows citizens to track the city's progress in addressing these problems. In 2014, the city received more than $17 million in Regional Development Authority funds. We have also become more vigilant in enforcing our building codes. And in 2014, the city demolished over 100 dilapidated structures. But we cannot rest. We must look toward the future. 2015, a year of positive change. Because of the investment in new technology and hiring of 25 new officers and purchasing 23 new squad cars and implementing new community policing strategy, crime is at its lowest level in 29 years, according to the Uniform FBI Crime Report. We will launch our Operation Stay Smart initiative that addresses truancy in the classrooms. It is our duty to make sure that our children are safe and they are on the right track. Our fire department will acquire another new engine in 2015, a second set of new personal protection gear. And we will hire 8 new firefighters, making sure that we protect those who protect us. Every employee will receive a 3% raise in 2015. And we will continue the practice of providing December bonuses for all of our employees. While we cannot change the minimum wage, which has been frozen for 20 years, we will assure that every employee receive no less than $10 an hour in recognition that employees deserve a fair wage for their hard work. By October 2015, the reconstruction of Main Street, along with 15,000 square feet in new commercial and retail development space, will help spur economic growth. Total investment, $3.3 million. Development of a new Unity Plaza. This $900,000 project will be completed in July. It will include a flower garden, ornamental lighting, cafe tables, green space, and artwork by world-renowned artist Tom Tolenki. We are investing $7 million in new development along our lakefront, adding amenities such as a splash pad, a steel mural by our own Steve Segura, shelters, landscaping, parking, and picnic areas. $1.3 million of improvement to Marina Drive in time for summer access and use to our marina and beach area. In 2015, we will invest more than $10 million as we begin an ambitious project to provide new amenities to our citizens with construction of 4 new field houses, Heritage Hall, Penn Center, Rock Center, and MLK Centers. Each facility will offer full-size basketball courts, a running and jogging track, workout areas, meeting rooms, and the opportunity for year-round fitness. We will finalize plans to build the city's first bike path along the Grand Calumet River. That will also provide a direct tie-in to the City of Hammond's award-winning bicycle trail. While our region discuss, they debate, they study options, we will showcase the East Chicago Bus Transit System as a successful example of how public transportation should operate. These efforts will include investing in two new paratransit vans, bike racks, and also we will improve all of the shelters across our city. The historical Carnegie Library was completely renovated into a children's museum and performing arts center. You was just given a performance by our children. This will give future generations opportunities that will result in amazement and admiration from our surrounding communities. Total investment, $3.3 million. We will invest $5 million in resurfacing our city streets this year. These numbers amount to 130 blocks that will be refinished in 2015. You can see that work as we speak. All told, we will invest more than $50 million in 2015. This is in addition to the $25 million we invested last year. Total investment in the last 2 years, $75 million. It lays the foundation for our citizens and businesses in our region to take pride in our city and encourage them to want to live in, invest in, and do business in the city of East Chicago. New business growth and job creation in 2015. Advance Auto Parts, 12 East Chicago jobs created. Dollar Tree, 25 employees, 23 are from East Chicago. Subway, 12 employees, 10 are from the city of East Chicago. The Millennium Project, you can see that along right off of Guthrie Street when you leave out of here. The Millennium Project, $35 million of investment in Lakeside Garden Housing Complex. 100 construction jobs, 20 are from East Chicago. In closing, we will continue to function with a balanced budget, demonstrating that we can live within our means. We have become an example of good and responsible government. Yes, a new day is dawning in East Chicago, one that is filled with hope and progress. As bright as today is, with your help and support, we will not rest on past accomplishments, for we know that our best days are yet to come. May God bless you, and may God bless this great city of East Chicago. Thank you.
Thank you, Mayor Copeland. Up next, we will have a video presentation by the Multimedia Division.
Sleeping in bed, no more backward thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There is so much hatred, war and poverty. Again, just you and me. Wake up all the doctors, make the old people well. They're the ones who suffer and who catch all the hell. They don't have so very long before their judgment day. So won't you make them happy before they pass away?
Just for the breath of life, I thank my maker. My mom say I come from hustlers and shakers. My mind building on skyscrapers and acres. He said, take us back to where we belong. I try to write a song as sweet as the Psalms. Though I'm the type to bear arms and wear my heart on my sleeve. Even when I fail in God, I believe. Read the days and weave through the maze. And the seasons so amazing. Feed them and raise them. Seasons are aging. Earthquakes, wars and rumors. I want us to get by, but we more than consumers. We more than shooters, more than looters. Created in his image so God lived through us. And even in this generation, living through computers, only love can reboot us. Come on.
Wake up, everybody. No more secret than
wake up everybody.
Yeah,
I said I need a little help.
I can't do it alone.
And now up next, we will have a musical selection by the Academy of Visual and Performing Arts, Youth Voices United.
Raise our peace. sad and sad and sad, more sad and south sad, Marchtown, new addition, with Calumet, East Calumet, Roxanna, East Chicago, Indiana, all around the world.
Just give them another round of applause. That was amazing. Thank you so much. And up next, we will have the retrieving of the colors by American Legion Post 369.
Legionnaires, halt. Black bearers, prepare to retrieve colors. Forward, march. Three colors. South face. Forward march.
Conclude, I would just like to thank you again for being here today for the State of the City here 2015. And also, there will be refreshments served across the hall. At this time, we will have the benediction by Captain Daniel Paredes.
Please allow me to read from the Bible, New Revised Standard Version, Psalm 121. Many of you may know by memory. It's a psalm of assurance from God's protection, and we need it. When things are going well and we are building something new, there is somebody who wants to destroy, right? And we know that. It's not you, it's not me, it's not flesh. The Bible said it's the spirit, the devil one, the evil one. And this song gives us assurance of protection. Psalm 121. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where will my help come? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep you're going out and you're coming in from this time on and forevermore. Yeah. Amen.
Thank you and have a wonderful afternoon.